Check it out. You never will be behind me. You never will be behind me. You never will be behind me. You never will be. Hey.
So we see that there are people breaking into a school. So what are they going to do? Are they going to steal answers for a big test coming up the next day? Or are they going to set up some sort of big prank for the teachers? Or... dancing. They break into the school for dancing. Idiots. You are all idiots. You could have been dancing anywhere else. A club, obviously. A block party, obviously. A haunted house that's seemingly abandoned. Weird, but yeah. But a school. You guys break into a school for dancing. How stupid are you people? I mean, these people look like they're about 16 or 17, right? So, normal high school students are more concerned about breaking out of school, not breaking into school to dance. If there are no other parties anywhere else, make your own. Dance at your own party. I'm pretty sure that these kind of schools have some sort of silent alarm system, and the authorities will immediately come and arrest all of you. This whole thing actually makes me want to run it over with an 18-wheeler. And then I would want to shoot it, bury it, burn it, bop it, twist it, pull it. So he sees this girl, and suddenly they decide that they should be together. I thought that trope died in the 90s, but no, it's still going strong here. So in some parts of this video, Chris Brown is either having some sort of epileptic seizure, or he's doing what he read on the internet as dancing. Aw, that's great, Chris Brown. Just kiss the girl you've only known for 3.5 minutes, have no idea who she is or what she's like, and show us what a great guy you really are. And so security comes in, and the party breaks out, leaving the security guards in the dark. Okay, there's some major things wrong with this. First of all, why didn't the security team come in when they heard the loud music? What are they, deaf? Second, the security team, duo, should have heard that the guy in lookout was shouting that they were going to be in there. That alone should have obviously alerted the security guards that people were in there. Third, are you telling me with all those people in that gymnasium, there was not one shred of evidence that there were people in there? Because there was a big turntable shown earlier in the video, and yet it disappears when the security guards come in. Did somebody just dismantle it really quickly? And speaking of getting out really quickly, there is no way that everybody would get out of there in 9 seconds flat. You could say that it was the editing of the music video, but 50 or 60 people were in that school, so you do the math. But back to the security duo, which is also known as the fourth problem. In high school, there are security cameras everywhere. So even if they didn't hear the loud music somehow, they should have at least saw the security footage and seen people there and immediately go stop the party. You know, now that I look at this video closely, I don't think they broke in. I just think the school has lousy security. Well, I don't think they have loud security. I know they do. Yeah, instead of doing something useful, just dance to the song that shouldn't be playing because the turntable is not there anymore. I think it's because the school realized that nobody will be stupid enough to have a dance party in the gymnasium. Idiots. What are you kidding? I hate this video. It was horrible in 2005, also known as the year the music gave up, and it's even worse now. I never knew that there could be plot holes in music videos. Plot holes! But this video proves me wrong. And oh dear, does it prove me wrong. If the next video I have to look at is worse than this, I'm gonna go into full-blown alcoholism.